Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the lead editorial. Now the lead editorial is written by Shiv Vishwanathan. Now this editorial is important from ethics mains examination paper 4 point of view. Now what is the central theme of this editorial? Recently we have seen that the major of army, Mr. Gogoi, he had tied up a man in front of his jeep in order to protect the election officials, electoral officials, from stone pelting. Now this editorial goes into the analysis of whether such an act by army is justified or not. Now there is a section of the society that is justifying this act on the pretext that it entails nationalism, it entails a very good strategy by the army to protect the electoral officials. And this has also been lauded so that in the future, army may be perpetuating, may be continuing with such kind of strategies. Abhi theme is editorial ka ye hai ki jo army personnel ne एक आदमी को जीप के आगे बिठा के इलेक्टोरल ऑफिशियल्स को प्रोटेक्ट किया स्टोन पेल्टिंग से, क्या वो सही है कि नहीं सही है? कुछ लोग इसको सही ठहरा रहे हैं ये बोल के कि ये एक नेशनलिज्म का थीम है, इसके नीचे जो अंडरलाई कर रहा है वो नेशनलिज्म है, देश की प्रोटेक्शन के लिए ऐसा किया गया. बट वॉट इज मोर ग्रेव इज दैट the army is putting at the stake the human rights of the society, human rights of the Kashmiri people. Because in order to protect few human beings, that is the election officials, you are trying to put at stake the people of Kashmir. You are trying to use them as a human shield. Now is it ethical? Now this can be asked in your mains examination. Is it ethical to use humans as the shield? Now the humans as a shield should not be used because it entails injury, it entails inflicting the thorns on the conscience of human rights. This is the foremost thing. Now the second thing that is most important is that by giving such a freedom to the army in order to inflict injury onto the human rights and the conscience of human rights, you're basically allying, you're basically justifying the brutality of the army. Agar aap ye sab kuch allow kar rahe ho, to ab kya justify kar rahe ho? Ki army jitni bhi brutality karna chahti hai, wo kare. Now this is only a part of the reflection of what army is doing. Now, we had other instances in the past, like numerous instances in the form of Armed Forces Special Power Act. Now it is not a matter of criticizing army, it is not a matter of criticizing the act of Mr. Gogoi. It is about the actions, it is about the conduct that is not in consonance with the spirit of the Indian Constitution. Agar aap Hindustan ke samvidhan se dekhe, if you view it from that perspective, not only from the perspective of nationalism, this act is not in consonance with the constitutional spirit. This act is not legitimized or justified by the constitution. And secondly, we have the conduct rules of the army. Again, this is not justified by that conduct of the conduct rules and the conduct code of the army. Now, if we view it from the perspective of human rights, not from the perspective of the conduct of the army or from the perspective of the constitution, again, this act is not justified. So there are three things which don't allow such a conduct from the army. Now fourthly, such an act is not right, keeping into consideration the kind of the situation Kashmir is currently in. Now what kind of a situation Kashmir is currently in? It is actually the battle going on between the army and between the Kashmiris. We really need to win the hearts and the minds of the Kashmiris. It's a battle of the minds and the hearts. Let's not make it the battle of the stones, pellets and bullets. Because if we will be making it the battle of stones, pallets and bullets, we will never be able to win the hearts of the Kashmiris. So where does the solution lies in? The solution lies in indulging in negotiation. The solution lies in checkered steps by the army. The solution lies in being, not indulging in an act that hits at the human rights of the people. Just fighting for their survival. Now, why I'm saying they're fighting for their survival? Because if you look at the entire Jammu and Kashmir, now Kashmir is one region that has been under a lot of stress and strains. Strains from the jihadists from Pakistan. They are not allowing them to live a proper life. It's from stress and strains because in order to protect the sovereignty and the integrity of India, army is indulging in some actions, and again the situation is very grave. Now just I will give you an insight about the students or the aspiring civil services aspirants in Jammu and Kashmir, because I keep visiting Jammu and Kashmir, specifically the Kashmir region, in order to teach the civil services aspirants. Now most of the aspirants in Srinagar, they are having some kind of a fear psychosis about their protection, fear psychosis about the security of the future, fear psychosis about to whom they really belong, because the area is really disturbed. And any such action, it will actually intensify the disturbance. So the government of India should come out with such a policy whereby we are able to not let the Pakistani infiltrators or the jihadists to percolate in Jammu and Kashmir and spread the wrong messages. So India needs to come out with some effective policy with respect to the cyber world, so that we don't allow the online propaganda being done by the Jammu and by Pakistan. And India also needs to come out with certain policy whereby we need to plug how ISIS is influencing the J&K youth. So this was all for the day. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 845-940-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.